Hello friends, welcome to PrepMate classes. In this lecture, we will learn about measures of government deficit. When government exercises fiscal policy, it incurs deficit. The expenditure of the government is usually higher than the revenue collection. Governments prefer to run in deficit because deficit enables the government to undertake welfare of the people. Before we understand deficit, let us first understand capital and revenue items of expenditure and receipts. Transactions can be divided into two types according to the period of time. Long-term period. Long-term period means the time period of more than 1 year. Transactions having long-term implications are capital transactions. For instance, building purchased by government will be used over many years. Thus, the transaction to purchase the building is a long-term transaction. Short-term period. Short-term period means less than or equal to 1 year. Transactions having short-term implications are revenue transactions. For instance, salary paid by government to its employees is only for rendering services in the current year. Therefore, the implications of paying salary are limited to the present financial year. Thus, on the basis of time period, transactions can be classified into two types, revenue and capital. Further, both revenue and capital transactions can be in nature of receipts or expenditure. Capital expenditures. Expenditures having implications of more than 1 year. For example, building purchased by the government. These expenditures are non-recurring in nature, that is, are not undertaken as a matter of routine. Revenue expenditures. Expenditures having implications of less than or equal to 1 year are called revenue expenditures. The benefit which the business gets is of short time period. For example, salary paid by the government. These expenditures are recurring in nature, that is, are undertaken as a matter of routine. Capital receipts. Receipts having implication of more than 1 year. For example, loans from public. If government takes loan, then it is required to repay the loan along with interest. These receipts are non-recurring in nature. Revenue receipts. Receipts having implications of less than or equal to 1 year. For example, tax collected by government. Government is not liable for anything in future for tax collected in the current year. These receipts are recurring in nature. There are various measures of government deficit from different perspectives to enhance analysis about the nature and cause of deficit. These are as follows. Revenue deficit. Revenue deficit is the difference between revenue expenditure and revenue receipts. Revenue deficit indicates that government's revenue expenditure exceeds government's revenue receipts. Fiscal deficit. Fiscal deficit refers to the excess of total expenditure over total receipts excluding borrowings during the given fiscal year. Fiscal deficit includes not just revenue expenditure and receipts, but also capital expenditures and receipts except borrowings. The extent of fiscal deficit is an indication of how far the government is spending beyond its means. Primary deficit. Primary deficit is one of the parts of fiscal deficit. While fiscal deficit is the difference between total revenue and expenditure, primary deficit can be arrived by deducting interest payment from fiscal deficit. Interest payment is the payment that a government makes on its borrowings to the creditors. Interest payments are excluded from calculation of primary deficit because interest payments are made on account of borrowings made in the past. This primary deficit specifies net impact of present transactions and includes impact of transactions undertaken in the past. Now, let us evaluate ourselves. Question number 1. Which of the following may cause fiscal deficit? Rise in government expenditure. This statement is correct. Increase in tax evasion. This statement is also correct. Increase in sale of assets. This statement is incorrect. Increase in sale of assets increases the capital receipts of the government and thus reduces the fiscal deficit. Thus, option A is the correct answer. Question number 2. Which of the following statements best describe the comparison between fiscal deficit and primary deficit? When the net interest payable by government is zero, then fiscal deficit is equal to primary deficit. Primary deficit is always higher than fiscal deficit. Primary deficit considers only revenue transactions, whereas fiscal deficit considers both revenue and capital transactions. Primary deficit considers only capital transactions, whereas fiscal deficit considers only revenue transactions. Option A is the correct answer because the only difference between fiscal and primary deficit is of interest payments. For best learning, you can watch this video along with PrepMate's Engage UPSC series, which is available online as well as offline. Book features: complete subject in a single book with practice and past year questions at the end of the chapters. Model answers for UPSC mains from authors. Using the application PrepMate and web portal prepmate.in, you can access comprehensive digital support in form of videos, mock prelims, answer writing practice, and regular updates.